All right, quick mailbag segment before an extended football pod in America. Let's start with Patrick Cipher. Here's the question. Do the Patriots have a chance at a Lombardi this year? Although we would all hate to see it, I wouldn't be surprised. Charean, your thoughts?
No, and I think it's the first time since 2008 that we're not talking about Patriots in the conversation for the Super Bowl, and that's the last time they didn't make the playoffs. But I think the Bills are going to win the division, so they'd go in as a wild card. They'd have to win on the road in the postseason a bunch of games. I think this is a fact Mike Unite right might know off the top of your head. I don't think the Patriots have ever won a Super Bowl when they didn't have the bye week, and they're not going to have the bye week this week, so I say absolutely not. They have no chance.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. There's only a couple times they didn't have the bye week that I can recall. One was against the Ravens 2009 season. They were blown off the field at home. And then last year, obviously, they lost on a Saturday night to the Titans. That run from 2010 through 2018, division title and a bye. Unbelievable when you think about it. It makes it easy to get to the AFC Championship game. All you have to do is win one home game, and there you are. I'm not ready to give up on them yet. I said it last year, and ultimately the Terminator was killed last year, but the Terminator is always possibly going to be back. And if I'm the Steelers, if I'm the Chiefs, if I'm the Bills, any of the other playoff teams, I don't want the Patriots getting in, because once you get to the postseason, everything changes. We know it every year. We know it's going to happen, but we don't feel it until it happens. That single elimination mindset, the pressure is higher. Everything's more intense. And Bill Belichick's been there and done that. And they've got plenty of guys in that locker room who've been there and done that. I don't want that kind of comfort with knowing that one loss means you're done in the postseason if I'm one of the teams that maybe doesn't have that kind of experience on my sideline. So I don't want them around if I'm one of these other teams. If they get in, and Steve Kornacki had the percentages the other night on Football Night in America, had them at 21% to get in, I believe. I think they got a better chance than that of getting in. It doesn't mean they're getting in, but if they get in, they're going to be a potentially dangerous team. JR, the boss man, do you believe Alex Smith has done enough to be in Washington next year as the starter, Charean?
Yes, I do. I think he has shown that he is a franchise quarterback. If that's what he wants to do, Mike, knowing his age, he may retire after this season. He may say, I've done enough. But, you know, we're ready to give him Comeback Player of the Year award just for suiting up, not even getting on the field. And then he got on the field and we're like, okay, he really deserves it now. But he's done more than that. I mean, he's set career best, back-to-back 300-yard games for the first time in his career. He's had a career best passing yards in a game this season. He really has been good enough for Washington to count on going forward. So it may be a case where you draft a guy, whatever, you decide that Dwayne Haskins is your guy, which I don't think they'll do that, but whatever. I think you bring back Kyle Allen and Alex Smith and find some young guy you believe in and start grooming him to take over the team when Alex chooses to leave. But absolutely, I think he's been good.
Coach Ron Rivera has already suggested that Alex Smith could be the future quarterback. There's an element that hasn't been relevant to the Washington football team in recent years, and that is they have the option to maybe try to squeeze him to take less. He's due to make $18.75 million non-guaranteed next year. You know, this year, they were going to pay him a $16 million base salary, whether he's on the team or not. That money was fully guaranteed, and it all goes back to that broken leg. He ended up getting 3 years of pay, fully guaranteed, because of the horrific injury he suffered. As of next year, they could move on, or they could say, we want you to take less. He's got a cap number of $24.4 million. That could be a preliminary hurdle two sides have to get over before anointing him as the guy moving forward. Another one from JR, the boss man. Dallas is probably going to give Mike McCarthy a mulligan for this season. Do you believe, Charean, that he will have to replace Mike Nolan as defensive coordinator?
God, McCarthy has been so loyal to his assistants over the years. And then we know all those cases when he should have moved on from them. So that's the only reason I pause for a minute. I think absolutely Mike Nolan should be gone. And Stephen Jones said on the radio today that this is basically the similar group of guys out on that field who last year weren't that inefficient against the run. Cowboys ranked last in rushing yards allowed, and they are last in scoring defense. I think he absolutely should be gone. I think the Jones family will force him to be gone and probably have the Cowboys go back to a 3-4 scheme next year.
Yeah, one or the other. You got to get players to run the Mike Nolan scheme or get rid of Mike Nolan and bring in a coach who can run a scheme that is built around the players they have. At Henry M. Huss 26H, how do you judge the race between the Steelers and Chiefs for the one seed in the AFC? The Chiefs have two games out of four left against playoff teams. Steelers have three out of four games against playoff teams. Shireen, I'll let you have the first crack at that one.
Well, I've already said I think the Steelers lose one, two, or three games closing this thing out. I just that kind of opened the door to what's going to happen here. I think they just needed to keep winning because they were going to lose at some point. I'm convinced of that, and I'm now convinced they're going to lose one or more games the rest of the way, and I think the Chiefs are going to win out. I think Chiefs get home field.
Miles Garrett suggested the door is open to win the AFC North for Cleveland. And you know what? You look at that schedule for the Steelers, Bills, Colts, and then the Browns, week 17. Wouldn't that be something if the week 17 game is flexed between the Steelers and the Browns into prime time with the AFC North on the line? Here's a real quick one that I'll answer on the way to break. On Tour Forever asks, do you think Trevor Lawrence will wait to see who the next Jets head coach is will be before making the John Elway, Eli Manning trade me decision? Unless they change the deadline, Shireen, mid-January is when you have to enter the draft. Unless the Jets get a coach in place by middle of January, Trevor Lawrence isn't going to know unless they let him know kind of behind the scenes who they're looking at. So he's going to have to make his decision, I think, before he knows who the Jets coach is. What do you think?
But he could force a trade, though, Mike, or say, I'm not playing for the Jets. He could make that move.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.